We cry out, you know, to the world, come to Christ, and all will be well. Come to Christ, and everything will go well. That's a lie. No wonder they run away faster than they come these days. When they find you lied, come to Christ and you'll prosper. Can you believe it? Where do you see that, brother? Give me one verse, I'll give you 20 for every verse you give to explain how you've taken the wrong context. You don't come to Christ to prosper. No wonder they come to Christ. Who wouldn't? You don't come to Christ for prosperity in finances. You come to Christ for mercy and brokenness, no matter what God does thereafter. You just want eternal life and you want forgiveness. There's no conditions attached. Don't put things out that aren't true. Coming to Christ doesn't make you prosper. That's a lie from the devil. He does prosper in times, but watch Job, how fast he can take it away. And where's your theologian there, all accusing you of sin? That's the only reason, like the theologians of Job, standing around him. No mercy, just couldn't be anything else but sin that God doesn't prosper you, you know. What trash. What trash we preach today. Stop it, preacher. Stop it. No wonder so many millions are bitter against God and against the church. We're lying. Beloved, let me tell you something. If you're not going to be true in the pulpit, get out of the pulpit. Get out. Get out. For God's sake and man's sake. It's not heaven on earth. It's not hallelujahs all the way. Show me one man that honestly can say that. No. And I have groaned. I can't stand here lying to you and telling you that I haven't groaned. I want to tell you what it is. Otherwise, I have to leave the pulpit. God told me that long ago. Don't worry about men's well done and smiling and hallelujahs, even if no one shouts hallelujah again till the day you die, Keith. Just be truthful. Someone's got to bring truth. It's not easy. It's not going to be easy, not for one of you, but trust God, it's precious. It's precious. I'll never forget the worst trials God ever allowed in my life. It was about 10 years ago. I'd been preaching for 30 years ago. I'll never forget down on my face, weeping in my office, back home, groaning before God. Why, God, why? Why, God, it's like the whole world. I don't think there was any soul left on earth that wasn't saying, why has God forsaken this man? Why has God forsaken this man? Was the cry of everyone that knew me. And everyone trembled to the degree that God had, it seemed, forsaken me. I was just a barren thrown down into the dust. And I grappled and I groaned and I wept and I aged. I aged 10 years in a few months. Don't doubt that. No one would doubt that. And as I was weeping, the phone went. They tell me my wife, children have been in an accident. The car right off in hospital. You know what I did? I just put the phone down. I didn't say a thing. And I got in my face and I said, for the first time in my life, from my heart, let me die. Let me die. Please, God, let me die. Is that Christianity? Was Job the only one that cried those words from his soul? Please, God, favor me with death. Was Jeremiah the only one that wept his face into the ground and said, let me die? No, no, brother. No, sister. But then, just in case you're all sitting thinking this man has got nothing but negativeness to offer the world, here comes the positive, okay? So grab it. There's always the end of a storm. Don't doubt it. There's no such a thing as God destroying a man in any fire. Don't ever doubt that. There's no possibility of God allowing you to be destroyed. There's not the slightest thought. Read Romans 8:31 onwards if you have. There's no shadow of a doubt. God won't allow you to be destroyed. Nothing would separate us from the love of God.